Best.
Bro. I'm gonna be a pet. Bro. Kelta.
Yeah.
Don't be that way.
I'm just bringing energy.
Bro.
Zesh consumes Ruin Hole.
Oh, thank God.
No, thank you.
Vor him, even.
Kelta. It's gonna be okay. Just give me your new character sheet and I'll draw them.
I did already.
You did?
It's there. It's there somewhere. It's up there. I wrote the whole thing already.
It's... You already you did?
Said, you said like, okay, and that was it.
When did you do this? When did you do this? Don't lie to me. I don't know when.
When I made the backup, I made it.
You know, why didn't you pin it? Did you pin it? Let's see.
No, probably not. Because you said okay, and then that was it.
Oh.
I mean, the character hasn't really come to light yet, so there wasn't really a point in doing the art for him.
No, I was just wondering because I wanted to make sure, just in case, if you wanted to make a new character or anything like that.
Well, if Ruin goes, he goes, and I'll make it, and a new character will be brought to light at that point. I'm not gonna purposely kill him or get him out of the way.
Okay.
It's just, it has to be like the game takes him, not I take him. So that's not really fun.
Thank you, B. Guys, B Dragon said, "Have a nice session."
Did you change your PNG tubers yet?
Yeah, I changed the PNG tubers, yes.
No, you didn't see Helly and her baby Bjorn.
Yeah, I already changed. That's why I was setting up everything.
How dare you? Helly wasn't ready for that. Helly wanted to be baby Bjorn.
So, you guys ready?
Never.
Dang.
Well. Anyway.
What happened last time? Do you remember? Last time. Were you there?
I wasn't here in the beginning, no.
No stuff.
I died. Didn't die.
Last time, we were walking through the swamps. Damn. And then there was a big evil smoke man. And we beat him up. And he tried to summon a zombie friend, but he was really bad at it. So his zombie friend was really far away. And we beat the big smoke man before the zombie man even became relevant, so he got to go back to sleep.
Yeah, he got to go back to nap.
We kept going into the swamp, and then everyone was just freaking out about something. I don't know what was going on, but we decided to leave, I guess. I don't know what was happening.
Yeah, it's invisible.
What was invisible?
You know.
Anyways, we found the alchemist lady's place. So we came up to the door and we were gonna go in, and then that's where we ended.
Nice. Why didn't
you, wait, hold on.
Wait.
Hold on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what?
You didn't put Lady Foxtrot 27 on your title.
Oh, did I not? I will.
Rude.
You're supposed to put her on there so we can follow her, even though she doesn't stream.
Well, I'm never gonna stream if no one follows me.
Yeah, yeah. Right? What the fuck? There you go.
She just wants the emote.
Yo, let's give Lady a shout out also.
Yeah, give her a shout out.
Wonderful and beautiful.
Kelly, don't tell them my secrets.
Lady wonderful and beautiful.
Yo, go check them out. Go follow them. They don't stream, but like, who cares?
No one can know that my plans are to stream until I have emotes and never do it again.
There you go.
Actually, Rhett told me about a thing that I can have emotes if I want to. I just need somebody to make the emotes.
Yeah.
I don't even have to be a Palladium for it.
I could be you have. You got three beautiful artists that
I'm not an artist because no one considered me one. What? You got three other artists to do emotes for you.
Yeah, we're talking about me, Goat, and Rat.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But Rat, is Rat back yet?
Yeah, no. I've been here.
What's the name of the thing you told me about with the emotes?
Better Twitch TV?
Yeah, that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that. Everyone uses that. It's
not everyone, but enough people.
A lot of people.
It's an extension you put on your web browser.
Mm-hmm.
Helly needs to know how to make a round thing with foam.
You draw a circle.
With foam. Physical form, not digital foam.
You draw a circle, cut the circle out, and then force the foam through it.
Oh yeah, we fought a giant fucking siren hydra, and then we dicked off.
A siren head?
A what?
We fight siren head?
Siren hydra.
Spear.
A what?
False hydra.
Of Siren Hydra, false Hydra. It sang a song and then it was a Hydra. It saw
it said Hail Hydra. It said Hail Hydra.
Hail Hydra, and then it stuck out its tentacles. And then
I don't think we fought anything like that.
And then Braum said, "Bubble trouble, you're in a bubble." And then
what you talking about? I don't remember this thing. I didn't see it.
Helly, I don't remember a lot of things in this campaign.
I don't remember half of the things in general of living.
That's a good point.
Alrighty, though. With that, what did that do?
What did you do?
I was moving a thing, and I guess if you hold it down too long, it just fucking disappears forever. Now I gotta pull it back up.
All right,
it does that on a normal basis.
All right, I got it pulled back up. As I was about to say, as we're getting started here, again, you've all wandered your way into this old dilapidated town. The building further up that has a dock attached to it is currently like half smashed. The only building is still in some form of repair is the one you're all currently in front of, which is Agatha's Wonders.
Who's getting inspiration for the recap, might I add?
Who has used it?
I do not have any, because I used it when I was almost eaten alive by my own cloak.
Might need to use it now.
You have a lot of stuff about getting eaten.
You know what?
It's the nature of being an owl. It's nature.
It's nature.
Eat or get eaten is essentially the, the law of mankind.
Vesh, you have inspiration, Rurin.
I do not. I just clicked
it.
What's up?
There you go.
Oh, freaking coyote outside my window sound like a donkey.
Hey, aww.
Yeah, but I realized it was a coyote and not a donkey.
Alright, who's knocking on the door?
I guess I'll knock on it.
Oh. I guess me and you were at the same time, and I'm like, go ahead. Go ahead, my friend.
I'll knock in the style of a shave and a haircut. Yeah. Shave and a haircut.
After a few moments, you'll hear some creaking floorboards as someone moves closer to the front door, and you'll hear a double knock before the door opens. hold on 1 second. I need to copy and paste.
Oh, cool.
Oh my god, why did they shrink that down? I don't like that it's small.
Kraku. I Kraku my way inside. Oh.
Alright.
Oh, Silent Hill, let's go.
Let me just reveal area. Okay, you can go away now.
Okay. Bye.
You got it.
Not you. revealing a rather old woman. She's very short and stout. She's hunched over with her age. Her hair is mottled gray and green with various mosses growing in her hair. She wears a almost like a witch's hat, but it has almost, it's almost like it's alive. It's a living plant, almost.
She got a mushroom head.
She looks around at you, Ruin, first you, and then Helly, and then as she brings her eyes over to Braum, she gets a little twinkle in her eye, and she, you can almost see how ecstatic she is. Oh, Ruin, you finally came home.
Do you
he is going
know?
To push oh. past you.
Ruin,
I'm going to need a strength check real quick.
Oh, okay. hello there. Strength check, you said, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Nope.
11.
11. No.
Alright, she got a 16. she has got one arm on your, like, she's taken her right arm and put it on your right arm, right around, like, the elbow area. It has moved you to the side as she steps out and embraces Braum in a hug.
Oh, how cool! This must be...
Visible tears running down her face as she cries out in happiness. Oh, I thought I'd lost you forever when those men took all the children.
Took the children, you say, Kraku. What?
History. You don't know this woman. You've never met her a day in your life.
I am holding my hands up. I don't know this woman. I have my arms up. I'm just
okay.
Arcana check, what are you checking for exactly, buddy?
Magic, this feels weird.
It is weird, but there's nothing magical currently going on as far as you can tell.
Can I roll perception?
you can roll insight to see if she's being genuine.
Okay, there's insight, there it is.
Oh.
You were going to, like, really look her over, but you kind of got distracted by some of the crunchy leaves on the ground.
Oh, such a helly thing, too.
After a few moments, she's going to, ruffle up, Braum's, clothing, trying to straighten out his shirt and such. Well, you all must be a mess, and thank you for bringing him home. And she's going to usher you all inside.
Ruin!
Hello? Come along, Ellie.
Rad, I was trying to get your attention earlier.
Oh, Ellie's gonna hold Braum's hand.
I'm playing Outbreak tomorrow.
Because Braum is Ellie's property.
With a streamer friend.
Oh, nice.
Alright.
With all of you inside, I'm gonna go ahead and boop.
She do got a mushroom head. What the fuck?
And she's a dwarf.
Bro. She's not actually a dwarf.
She could be a gnome.
She could be a gnome.
Yeah, maybe.
I have a mushroom hat.
She is marked as being human.
Nasty.
Oh, so she's just a small person.
Yeah, she is just old and shrank over time.
Or she was never that big to begin with.
There's also that possibility.
Men in black cloaks. Okay, Organization 13. The rest of the villagers.
Oh no, this is like that Final Fantasy VII village. Where everybody...
Oh, yes! can I investigate to see what these are?
Alright.
Or do I know these? Can I roll nature to know the stuff on the dressers and tables?
Oh, you got somebody here who could tell you.
You don't have to rummage through the old lady's stuff. You could always just ask.
I'm looking at it with my eyes. I'm not rummaging through anything.
Mm.
I just realized I misspelled Braum's name.
No.
It's okay. I wasn't going to say anything about it.
Is it the lady that can tell me, or who is it?
Yeah, whose shop is this?
I don't trust her.
I don't think anyone knows.
Can I roll a nature check? I'll have to if you don't want me to.
you're checking the various potions on the shelf over here?
Yeah, just like the ingredients and all that type of stuff that's on the dressers and shelves and tables.
Go ahead and give me an intelligence check.
Oh, I'm not smart enough for that.
Helly can help you.
Oh, I got a 15.
15. Right. Looking over the shelves, you see various books on potion making, alchemy in general. You'll also see some for picking herbs and what kind of herbs are useful. On the top shelf, you'll see various potions. The top shelf is only about chest height, by the way. You'll see various potions, such as ones you recognize as the normal potions of healing and the potions of greater healing, as well as some other potions you do not recognize, which are various shades of greens, purples, and blues.
Oh, how many favorite colors.
Many of the ingredients on the other shelves, such as over here, are those used in making the potions, as well as the tools needed to do so. Many of them are aligned as if the tools are being sold as kits.
Oh. Okay. Well, all right then.
Yes?
After the old lady situates herself back in her rocking chair, staring a bit at the stew she has over the fire, she's going to turn and look at you. Oh, it's so good to have you back in the house, dear. Would you peel it off and go get my blankets? I'm feeling a bit tired.
All right, then. Can I roll an insight?
Yes.
Not to be like, I'm mistrusting her. It's more of like, maybe she has like a, she's like looking towards somewhere specifically, so I can be like, oh, I know exactly where that is.
Oh, be nice to the old woman. She wants to come.
Yeah, natural 20, baby.
She is pointing around the corner over here.
All right.
However, when you see her looking at you, you're going to notice her eyes aren't so great.
Yeah, I had suspected that it was actual old age.
She has a bit of a milky whiteness to them that tells of her cataracts.
Yeah. Not a problem, of course. If you don't mind, my friends are here, and they also would not mind helping you out. Dear friend Bruin over here, and... and good friend Helly, and there's also lovely and amazing Shink and
oh, wow, you just forget Lady and this follows her character's name.
Yeah.
Is that just you today?
Zesh. And our good friend Zesh.
I'll open the door.
Yes.
Zesh, you'll watch as he points at you when he's trying to introduce you and just opens and closes his mouth a few times and then remembers your name.
He's like snapping his fingers like, oh, it's my tongue. What is it?
Oh. Beautiful booby lady over there.
Yes. Dear friend Zesh, we will grab your blanket. Not a problem. Ruin, if you don't mind. Let's see.
Opens the door.
Opens the door on this side.
Give me just a second.
Walks in. Sleight of hand roll.
Right, Ruin, you found yourself in a supply room. There are a few what appear to be locked chests, as well as various ingredients and some potions that haven't yet been placed out on the shelves.
Can I roll? I guess investigation to see if I know these potions or medicine.
Looking at the potions, they all seem to be the exact same ones you saw out on the shelves. These just haven't been stocked out because the shelves are still full, as there's not really a whole lot of market to sell them to it currently.
Can I roll like? Okay. I'm very skeptical of this place.
That's wrong.
You have found yourself in her bedroom.
Oh, good place to, as any, to find where her things are. Come along, Kelly. Let's see if what we can bedroom? Find her.
Why is there like a double-sided?
What's easy. That about? It's because you only need one hearth. You need to heat both rooms.
Heating the main room and have it connected to the bedroom? That's like just. Yeah. Just that's just smart.
Yeah, I don't understand what you're like. This is like normal design for older houses. What do you mean?
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
I want to look out the window.
Hello, could you help me out? I will roll a perception check. I give Heli an advantage. On perception.
How in the world of perception? Okay, let's see.
Yeah.
Well, looking on her bed, you'll see her blanket.
Oh.
What about the window?
Helen must take the blankie.
The window points outside.
Can Helly have the blankie?
It's so dark outside.
Oh. Can Heli have the blankie?
Yes, you Heli walking up to the bed, you would pull the blanket off of it.
Can Shank give her a fox pelt?
She'll look at the fox pelt and gently clasp your hand a bit. Oh, thank you, dear, but that's all right. They can eat my blanket for me.
So, girl, what if Heli didn't come back with the blanket and she just pockets the blanket? Be like, I don't know, I didn't find her.
Did you find her blanket, Heli? All right.
I feel like stealing from this thing will like activate a hag secret boss.
I think we should just be nice. But and that's
I'm
just
all down for it.
Heli doesn't want to be nice.
There you are, dear Heli. Give her blanket. Do you
Helen gives her her blanket.
Can I open one of these chests, I suppose?
I suppose.
Oh, goodness gracious.
Taking the blanket graciously from Heli, she would put it over her lap as she leans back in her rocking chair. Oh, I truly thought little Rowan had been lost. When those men in cloaks had come into the village and started grabbing up all the children, I thought when they had grabbed Rowan, it was the last I would be seeing of him. But he's here now.
We still have a child in the party.
If your friends like, they can help themselves to what's available. There's no way to buy it anymore.
Oh.
If you don't mind, though, I think I'm going to take a little rest.
Oh, of course.
I'm gonna wake up.
Forever?
As her voice gets lower and lower, she'll say, "Welcome home, Rowan." And you'll see her skin start to change.
Oh.
Slowly becoming bark as she transforms into a small tree.
Oh, yahaha, you found me.
Yahaha, you found me.
Yeah, she died. She passed
she's
away.
A tree now.
She's a tree now. But yeah, she isn't dead. She just changed to another form.
Yahaha, you found me, as they say.
I must say.
All right, friends, I found what? What happened? What did you do?
20 arcana, unnatural.
Looking at the older woman and rolling and both rolling so high, you'll see that she was a druid.
Oh.
And that her old age had just finally caught up to her. Like all druids, she would become one with nature.
Did she die?
Yes.
Unless she was a druid, so like.
She's not technically dead, she just rejoin nature.
Is her roots actually going to the ground, or are they stuck in the okay.
The floorboards that she was touching, as well as the rocking chair, have actually sprung back to life, as it were, as her roots now extend underneath the house.
Oh, good. Well, no, she didn't die. She became one with the with nature itself. This is natural.
That's like saying the people you buried didn't die; they just turned to grass.
But we can, we literally can tell she's right there.
She's dead.
We could probably, if we had a druid in our party, they could probably talk to her right now. Because they can talk to plants and animals. They have a spell like that. It's really cool. It's really cool.
Kelly doesn't know what a druid is.
Red thing in her room. Which red thing?
The red thing in the corner.
I mean,
which corner? There's a few red things in corners. Yeah, okay, that thing. Right here, that thing is obviously a chest.
Okay, that's all I'm wondering. I mean,
that's more of a brown, but okay.
I can't tell with the lighting. It looks red to me.
You're gonna open it? It is not locked.
Okay, I'll open it.
Opening it, you will find a few trinkets. You also find a small wooden carving of a family portrait of what appears to be the younger version of the older woman standing next to a young boy who is a little short and stout, and if you squint your eyes, you could probably mistake him for Braun.
Okay.
If you really squint your eyes.
What was the other thing? The first thing?
You find a robe colored, a vest. A vestment covered in moss.
I guess I'll take the vest.
It's a vestment. I think it's a gambeson.
Oh, gambeson. Yes, I'll take the gambeson. I also, in memory of her, I'll take the portrait. This seems interesting. So I have something for my stories.
Oh, it is a gambeson.
If the cat looks like Braun, it has to be Braun because she used Braun's name and not any other kid name.
She called him Rowan.
Yeah, she called him Rowan. Rowan.
What was it? Wooden sculpt?
A wooden carved portrait.
Well, wooden carved portrait.
You have also you have the gambeson of the mossy grove.
Oh.
Well, Ellie. Well.
Wait, how the hell are you supposed to?
Why she needed that blanket? Like.
I mean, is it keeping her warm?
Dude, she's a tree.
Never mind, we'll figure it out when we get there.
Zish. Could I ask for, maybe you could do some last rites or something? Or?
I don't know what you want me to do. You just told us that she's not dead, so.
I mean, it is still. Look at Shane.
I could fix that for you if you want.
Oh no, she's become one with the earth. I'm saying more of like,
go. I could literally kill her immediately if I wanted to.
True.
I have a spell that will just decimate her because she's a plant now.
Yeah.
I mean, Heli could too. Heli likes fire.
We all could. We could all kill her, but no. What I'm saying is that it seems that our poor friend Shink seems a bit rattled. I mean, look at her. She seems a bit rattled by it. It's okay, Shink. I didn't know her. Nobody knew her. And she has become one with the earth. Yeah. Truly, this is what all druids strive for.
I guess I'll take some of the potions in this room.
Yeah, Rulin seems completely fine with it.
Alright, roll me a d6.
Zash seems fine with it.
Shanks just gives him a blank stare.
I know, it's very difficult.
Alright, give me another d6.
One.
Alright, go ahead and add 3 potions of healing to your inventory.
Hey, alright. I guess I'll try and open the chest in here too.
There are 2 chests, both are locked.
Is it a regular
potion? Who can Helly try?
Hey, Mel, hope you're doing well.
Yes, they're just regular potions of healing.
So I'm at 5.
Sash is currently trying to formulate in her head what the heck she's going to do now that there's no alchemist to talk to.
Oh, shit. Yeah, he did need to talk to one.
Oh, yeah. All right, we needed to talk to one.
Which one? Are they both locked?
You can check the notes.
Are they both locked?
Yes, both chests in there are locked.
You know, you have two skilled pickpocketers, or not pickpocketers, lockpick people in your party.
Yeah.
You could always ask. But you're not. But you would have to share the bounty.
But you're not in the same room as me.
Neither of us are in the same room as you.
Mm-hmm. A bit of well, but surviving. How about you? We're doing good. I think we're doing good. Right, guys?
Can I attempt to pick up without lockpick tool?
Sure. Give me a dexterity check.
With my claws, I do that. Damn, that almost was a 20.
Don't worry, even if it was a 20, you still would be getting this thing open.
Okay.
You fiddle with the locks a bit, trying your fingernail. At your current roll, I'd say it does chip a bit of your fingernail.
Damn, okay. Well, I'm gonna read this book, this journal.
Ruin, looking down at the book in front of you, you can't make heads or tails of the words written in there. In fact, you're not even sure it's a written language.
Damn. Is this also a chest?
That is also a chest, yes. Anything that looks like a chest is usually a chest.
I don't know, it looks like a barrel from the top. Alright, I'll open that.
There's also a small open wardrobe over there.
Okay, I'll look at that later. What's the chest?
That chest is also unlocked. Inside, you will find... Give me a second to pull up the table.
Can I roll Arcana on the book? Is it like an Arcana thing? Like magic? Or is it like I just can't read the language?
We're doing good. So far in the game, we were going to an alchemist. Blind. And she died of old age.
No, yeah. If you look far back, you'll realize this journal starts at the beginning of the year. However, she still is blind at that point.
Alright.
And that journal should right in the bud. Give me a d6.
Got it. 5.
5. Give me a
d12.
Nine. Alrighty. Where is it? Oh, alrighty. Here we go. Alright, first thing you will find is a small club of, it will have what's apparently like, almost like the hand of a nature elemental. This one's holding a boulder.
This one's like a very sick.
Like a small boulder, it has moss growing on it, and it's got some leather wrapped around the hilt.
Yeah, this was her beating scoop.
That's the first one you find, and roll me another d12.
You got it. It's cursed.
with her husband. Helly,
bro, Helly's always cursed. Just look at her.
And four. Right, you right. will find.
Oh, I can. Oh, this is like that one thing.
You will find a single leather bracer. It has it is chased in silver with a single emerald embedded at the forefront of it.
I'm just typing in the mossy thing in my items. Alright, and what was it? One what? Bracer. Is it mossy? Oh, there it is. Emerald stag. Didn't we get this a long time ago?
I believe you had the option to buy it from a shop.
Yeah. We had the option.
Oh. Requires a tomb by a ranger.
Thank you, Helly.
I'm checking
that. I both wear this bracer and the other bracers. Double bracers.
Okay. It's not in your guys' inventory. You guys did see it at a shop at one point. But you probably saw it at a blind dude shop.
Into the cape it goes.
Go should see the thing I sent him.
I did see it.
Alright,
I put it in
the cape. Everything's in the cape. Cape.
Cape.
Alrighty.
What's in the wardrobe?
Looking in the wardrobe, you'll see some old, mostly moth-eaten clothes. However, tucked away in the very back, you will find a greatsword.
A big, is mossy greatsword? So much moss.
I got a problem with, moss.
Oh, that's fuzzy, gross, gets everywhere.
Rather than mossy, this has vines growing on it. The greatsword seems to be made of marble.
Vine sauce, you say? Marble, okay.
Bitty vine
it just
sauce.
Sounds like you're talking about Halloween.
This is the second time we've had this sword.
Hell yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
Shit.
I might still be carrying the old one.
Yeah.
Go ahead and get rid of that. Roll me a d6 for me.
Wow.
I'm going to Reiki roll through the great swords.
Retconned sword.
We could have had dual swords.
A 5. Alright. Oh, hey. This one is also plant themed, so it still works.
Hell yeah.
You find the Astroroot blade.
Okay.
The Interfert?
Is this even a great sword? I thought it was. Oh, it's a long sword. Same thing, whatever.
Long sword and great sword.
They are two different things.
I understand that, yeah. the two-handed swords, yeah. They both count as long swords.
What is everything you're throwing at us that always needs attunement? Why can't it just be really good?
It's to make you min-max yourself. Right. You decide what you want and what you don't want. Unfortunately, in your case, most of the stuff you tend to put on is really cool-looking because it's really cursed.
Yeah, that's okay.
Dude, it's so cursed. Bro, that shit's so cursed, my man.
I have a question that is very controversial. Oh. It's extremely controversial, actually. Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna DM it to you. I don't feel incredibly safe asking questions.
Go ahead.
I also sent something to Goat.
I'm curious.
It's funny.
I know. I saw.
I don't know if that's a possible.
I saw
thing.
What you said. You said pony.
If it is, I might just do it. That doesn't matter. But alright, that's fair. I will accept those terms and agreements.
You should right, accept then. It.
And the last thing I'm gonna do is eat some of that soup she was making.
And
alrighty, you gotta try some of the soup. Yeah. Give me that soup. The spoon first.
Give me that soup.
Sure.
Give me that soup.
I'll give it two huffs and puffs.
Alrighty.
One huff this time.
Taking a sip of the mushroom soup she was making. It is rather nice tasting. It has an almost creamy texture to it. You're going to go ahead and gain 10 temporary hit points.
Oh, yeah.
For the next 24 hours.
And sprout mushrooms on your head.
Oh, is this like grandma's soup from Wind Waker? Will I get like double my stamina?
I mean,
no.
She is a grandma.
Well, thank you, old lady. Krakku, and I'll move on. Is there anything in this book? In the middle of the table?
Opening the book, you will see it is research notes as well as... I forget what they call it again. Now I'm doing the snapping thing. It's a ledger for the purchases and such made in the shop. You'll see most of them are very old.
Okay. Well, I believe that I am done with what I'm doing, so if anyone wants to take some potions, go right ahead.
I want to lay down.
Go lay down in her bed. Go sleep in her bed.
I'm trying to decide whether I want to light a black candle about my issue.
What does a black candle do?
We've got magic black candles. Don't worry about it.
We do.
They're not black flame candles, so you don't have to worry about that.
Yeah.
No witches?
No witches.
I'm gonna open these back doors.
Those just lead back outside.
Okay. And then the wolves come from off-screen and drag me away.
Damn. Where'd Ruin go? I guess he's just going to get a bite to eat. We'll find him later.
Well, shall we continue on, Krakku?
I guess. It's not much we can do.
Ruin says as he nonchalantly jumps over a table.
Whoop. Yeah, okay. Are you going to roll acrobatics for that?
Nah, I'm just being, you just stepped on it.
No, I will. I will acrobatics to jump over this table. Believe me, I will.
Guess we'll just have to keep looking for an opening.
I just want to see it. Hell yeah. Whoop.
You do a small somersault over the table.
Hell yeah, I do a front flip. Well, that was interesting. No idea how we're going to find the trail to where we're going, but, you know, we'll figure that out, Krakku. I'll walk outside.
I don't think anybody expected that one. Alright.
He's the only one that knew. And now we don't know.
Oh well.
So that is an ordeal when it gets to that.
Oh well.
Ruin, as you step closer to the old tree, you'll see what was once her face slowly open an eye. Oh, yes, dear.
What? It's Grandmother Willow! What the fuck? Alright.
I told you guys, she wasn't dead.
I never said she was.
I heard you guys talking about killing me.
hello there.
To be fair, I didn't say nothing about killing her.
Yeah.
I never said anything about killing her either. No one did, except for Braun.
I never said anything about killing her. I just said...
If she could read last rites or something, it's like, it's just like
different.
You just told us she's still alive. What do you want me to do about it?
Yeah, she's one she's one with nature.
Ooh, hello there. He waves over to
where?
To the grandmother willow tree.
Very cool. Could be a bit more specific, dear. I'm not as young as I once was.
What?
I believe I misspoke and said Ruin instead of Shank.
Ah, yes.
Yeah, I have no idea what just happened.
I did.
I was very confused.
Yeah, Shink walked up to the old tree lady, and I'd accidentally said Rurin.
Listen, I'm operating on like 4 hours of sleep.
Aw. You need rest.
I'll rest when we're done. But yes, Shink, she is addressing you.
Lost?
She'll close her eyes a bit and ponder the question. Or rather, statement. What are you trying to get to, dear?
The Shink just looks at Zesh, since she has a limited vocabulary.
We've been having a lot of trouble with those bad men that took your grandson. And so our friend of ours is in need of help, and he's in Waterdeep, but we don't really know where we are right now.
Oh, that's terrible. Well, currently you are in the, as I pull up the map to get the name. That is the wrong map. Currently you're in the Mere of Dead Men. If you travel further east along the way, same direction you came in from the town from, it'll take you straight to the high road.
Oh, thank you.
Yes. Okay.
And now we're back over here. I bet she'll
leave her like a little water skin, I guess.
I bet she's just going to close her eyes and resume her nap.
She's a comfortable tree.
Zesh is gonna ask her about the heckin' spooky eye she's been carrying around.
you still could.
Yeah, Zesh is doing that.
The wolf eye? The eye of the weeping wolf? Are you going to show it to her, or are you just going to ask her about it?
I'm going to be prepared to show it to her, but not pull it out if she seems uncomfortable about it.
I'm going to... Boom. Oh, she actually has extensive knowledge on that. Dear, if you, drain the fluid from the eyeball into a flask and heat it over a fire for about 30 or so minutes. It'll turn crystal clear, and if you drink it, you'll be able to shift in between the planes for a few moments. Specifically, I believe the ethereal plane.
Lane shifting.
I like this old lady.
Yeah, she does. I like most old ladies. They're nice.
Shink will do a little bow and head on her way.
Is anybody else going to help themselves with some potions or no?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure, I'll come back.
You've already had your share of potions.
I'll grab some potions and then just some Verbius ingredients. Like, referencing my potion book.
Referencing your potion book, you'll take a... you'll receive... Hold on, there's an actual thing for this, if I can remember what it's called. Alright, you will find yourself an alchemist kit, as well as a components pouch. For storing the various alchemical ingredients.
Did Ruron open those chests back there?
Yeah. Not in the ones in the storage room. Those were locked.
I'll go open those.
Damn. Okay.
Alright, give me some lockpicking rolls. You'll need two. Because they're just, they're locked.
I forget how to do lockpicking.
You'll press on the lockpicking tools on your proficiencies, and then you'll press dex.
I'm clicking on thieves tools, it's not doing anything.
Let me pull up your sheet here, shrink. Are you clicking at it underneath where it says tools, pro, and attribute?
Yeah. I'm clicking on thieves tool.
So when you click on it, is it turning red when you hover your mouse over it?
Yes.
And you click on it and an input value doesn't show up?
Nothing shows up. It's just nothing.
Try closing your sheet and reopening your sheet.
What is that? Oh, I fucked that up. It used strength.
Oh, I have it set to dexterity. Seems to be working just fine.
Oh, and it says input value attribute strength.
Close out your sheet and reopen it again.
Oh, now it's not closing. Can I just roll dexterity?
You already rolled twice, you don't need to. You got high enough rolls to unlock them both.
Okay. It won't close.
It won't close? Can you move it around?
I cannot.
You may need to refresh your page.
Okay, I'll be right back.
All the technical difficulties of making awesome rolls.
I'll say again.
Technical difficulties.
Oh.
It's okay, you're all good, buddy.
I wanna roll for potions.
Give me 2d6 then. One at a time, please. Alright, a 5. And a 3. Alright, go ahead and add to your pack. 3. Three potions of resistance.
So what were in the chest?
Alright, in the chest. For the first one, we're going to do... this one right here, give me a d6. And a d12. Alrighty. Soon as I can pull it up here. Guys are at a point where I have to double check that I'm not double putting stuff on the fucking tables and giving them back to you. Alrighty. Alright, so the first thing you're going to find is a bandolier. It is a leather strap that holds 6 daggers in it. All 6 daggers are fastened, and it just, for all intents and purposes, looks like a normal bandolier daggers. Can but you... holding it in your hands... What?
Can you type that out?
Bandolier?
Yeah.
That is the only thing that you'll find in that chest. For the chest number 2, give me another d6 and another d12. A 1 and a 4.
Oh, the bandolier thing, it doesn't require attunement, right?
You have no idea. I haven't given you the thing because you haven't been able to identify it yourself.
Dang.
I'm just trying to find where your item is. Okay, I found it. You find a small glowing green gem. I'll go ahead and put this in the Discord. Alright, and roll me another d12. A 3. Thank you. find a small perfume bottle.
Oh.
The bottle is red and seems to be rather odd looking. It's almost like the bottle itself is held within the mouth of some golden little beast. It has a little circular pair of horns at the very top and the little balloon that helps spritz out the perfume itself looks almost to be made of flesh.
Ew. Okay.
You will also find a coin pouch. Give me a second because I have to make the roll for this. All right. You are going to find exactly 1,000 gold.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, I never thought I'd roll a 000. All right.
I gotta start putting things away with that pick and lock, but...
Well, pick and lock can only hold one thing.
Only one thing?
Yeah.
Aw. I'll also, do that later.
Also, you got a Bron here if you want to show him that bandolier.
I'm right here.
Okay.
Alright, I'd look at the bandolier. I'm looking at it.
Heck, give me an arcana check.
Alright, I'm giving that arcana check, you betcha. 19, baby.
19. Alright, not only do you identify this as a magic item, you even tell Shink what it does. It's in the item cards now.
Mm-hmm. Let's see, bandolier. The bandolier of elements. This cross-chest bandolier has 6 magic daggers sheathed across it. When you take an attack action while wearing this bandolier, you can use a bonus action to throw one of the daggers, making a range attack with it, provided you have a free hand. When you hit the target with one of these daggers, roll a d6 and consult the table below. The target takes an extra 1d6 damage of the type of determined in the table, in addition to the weapon's damage, and the dagger disappears. On a miss, the dagger vanishes and reappears in the bandolier. The dagger vanishes if you don't hurl it right away and immediately reappears in the bandolier. 1d6 missing daggers reappear in the bandolier's empty sheets daily at dawn. And it changes from acid, cold, fire, lightning, poison, thunder. So it's basically your mind daggers, but now it's a physical item.
And there's a 1 in 6 chance you might hit something that might be weak to whatever it is you hit it with.
Yeah.
I'm just saving these cards right now.
One of them isn't even a real, like, element type. It's, there's lightning and then they have thunder on
there. One sound, one's,
yeah. One dagger hits you and it immediately explodes with the loudest sound you've ever heard.
Yeah.
Okay, I think I saved all of them.
Yeah, I had to pump that down.
I'm gonna show Bron an item.
What's up?
I want to show Bron the skull cap I have. It has a pretty blue glow on it.
I shall look at it. I shall look at it with enthusiasm. 27.
Natural 20.
Blah, blah, blah.
Right. Give me just a second. Did I ever make card for this.
Did I ever do make a card for this?
I do have to take knives out for a sec.
Go ahead. We'll take a short 5-minute break then.
Okay.
La 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 la. Scooby.
Scooby. Stretch and grab some ice cream.
Yeah. Stretch and grab some ice cream. Helly.
Swing.
You can stretch and grab some ice cream.
Helly doesn't have ice cream.
Do you have those strawberries that you made?
I've had too many.
Oh.
Helly fat. Too many strawberries.
I sent you something.
Oh, for Helly.
Look.
You should help me. Oh, didn't know you were doodling that.
You sent me it to doodle it.
Yeah. I'm not okay.
What? Did you call him gay? And gay?
Oh, I see your doodle. My Peter Griffin there.
It's because they're funny.
I draw peepees.
You draw peepees.
Oh, there it is. Okay, I was like, where the fuck did I put it?
So, I drew that, and now I gotta draw you. It's Scooby-Doo.
It's in, item cards.
Okay. I hope you like Scooby-Doo.
Yeah, it's Skullcap confused with something else. It was a home. I mean, yeah, it's just a fucking helmet. Why wouldn't they call it a helmet? Why do they call it a Skullcap? That fucking makes no sense. Well, yeah, whatever.
It's weird.
I was like looking for the word Skullcap in my fucking table.
Helly. Is Helly so? Helly.
Helly, we have gone to go get somebody to eat or drink.
Helly is here.
Helly. Oh, Helly's here.
Helly's here, do you want to be a little bean?
Yes, in a Scooby costume.
Okay. Got it.
And Peter Griffin.
And Peter Griffin. Peter, I'm holding drinks. Lady, she's holding drinks.
I'm going his gay legs.
My gay legs. The legs.
You know the bloopies are fake.
Oh. I go get snack.
Go get think boobies.
I got cashews.
I am him.
Look, Alpha. Yeah. How are you liking the Druid themed items?
It's interesting. In my pockets. I'll never use them. Sadly, I'll tell you that. I'll never use them.
Are we about to leave the house now?
No, Bron's standing in the way.
Also, we're taking a short break.
Yeah.
I don't know if you heard me when I said that.
No, that's fine. I know.
We're just chilling out. We're just chilling out, man. Kelta? You ever just chill out, veg out, listen to the frogs in the swamp? Wait. And look at little Howie's.
Just wants to know how to make a spear.
Mm-hmm.
You take a stick and then you sharpen one end. There you go.
A sphere. Is that better?
A sphere.
Sphere.
Out of foam, right?
Mm.
Do you have a wire?
A what?
Do you have wire? Like metal wire?
No.
No?
No.
If you did, you could attach a small amount of heat to it and then use it to cut the... You could shape it into like a half circle and then use it to melt through the foam.
Mm-hmm. You could do a hot wire tool.
How thick of foam do you think I have?
I'm not entirely sure. You could also do layers, like how they do cakes, but just make each layer slightly smaller in diameter. I would say use a compass for that.
You make them
and then you glue them all together, and then you just sandpaper it down.
Big I'm not sure.
I'm not sure what kind of foam we're working with here.
1 to 2 inch.
Yeah, do the layer method then. That works.
But it needs to be hollow.
Yeah, you can hollow it out. Just glue it together. And make like a little... Just like do the circle thing, but do it on the inside and the outside diameter.
Should be easier way to figure out how to do that. Because this is what I want to make. I put it in memes.
I thought you were gonna put it in chat. Let's see here.
There's a species that looks exactly like it. And I want one. And I have enough fur to make one. I just need to know how to make a round circle out of foam. And no one's showing me how to, and it makes me angry.
Why don't you just, you know, put the foam on a ball?
It doesn't work like that.
Hey, Hucklejack. Hi, Hucklejack.
No, I bet you could do it with a ball. Like a basketball.
Maybe.
You
know what? I don't have one of those, but that is an idea. I can make a pattern off of that.
You just go to Walmart. Basketball's like, what, $5? I don't actually know how much a basketball's worth. I've never bought one.
Neither do I.
$20, my man.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Look at one of those cheap little bouncy ball ones that they put in like the big old...
How much is a basketball? Let's see... shut up. It's not that expensive. No, it's not. It cannot be. No, it can't be that okay. I was like, oh, someone said it's $400. I'm like, bullshit. It's $400.
That better be that brand new one with all the holes through it.
Yeah. It's $20. $20 for a really good one. Oh, you can get a Wilson Evolution game basketball for $80. No. Kids getting... You can get... Oh, my God.
Is that the one that's just hollow and has, like, all the holes through it?
No, it's just a Wilson. It looks exactly the same as the other Wilson. They look exactly the same. There's no difference.
One part made with real leather.
Probably.
If it's $80, it fucking better be.
Better fucking be.
Something better have died screaming and had like the skin ripped from it to make the leather for that damn ball was $80.
And Zesh picks up Brawn and crumples him into a ball. And starts bouncing him.
I'm
going to need a dexterity check.
From me or from her?
From Zesh.
From Zesh. Is she balling? Is she balling?
19. She is balling. She is in the basketball stance. She is she's like ducking, dodging, and weaving. She's moving the ball back and forth between her hands and her legs.
Oof. Oh. Damn. Damn, she's powerful.
I think we're just waiting for a rat to get back.
Yeah.
Broadcaster, the foam ball. How freaking dare you? Angers me. There's only one thing that usually gets casted in foam balls, and it's that EVA foam, or not EVA foam, that toxic foam you can't use.
Mm-hmm.
I'm tempted, but I do want to survive the rest of my life, so I'm not that tempted.
Just do like what everybody else does and make it out of asbestos.
No. First you turn me out of asbestos. Bad.
But yes, Uncle Jack, thank you. You're incredible.
Oh, how are you keeping this?
Thank you for coming in. Thank you for being so awesome.
But how are you trying to make one of these creatures? And I don't know how. I don't know.
I like cashews, but I can't eat too many of them.
Hey, sometimes that happens. Oh, I ate a pickle the other day for the first time.
Bro, I love pickles. I'm like, boy.
Look, I like pickles. It's just there's the same problem I have with all vegetables. I love the taste. I love the feeling. But when that crunch hits, that's when I'm like, ugh.
Buddy pal, chum. Cucumbers are fruits.
Yeah, well,
they have seeds.
Okay.
Anything that has seeds, they're fruits. Vegetables don't come with seeds.
You're a little off on your herbology there, somebody. Oh god. Okay, so fruits have do have seeds, yes, as do vegetables. Vegetables also have seeds. What do you think peas are?
Peas have seeds.
What about the tomato thing?
Tomatoes are fruits. They are a lot of the time with seeds. Hold on, this is a fucking thing. I gotta pull this up because I'm working again, 4 hours of sleep, and I'm trying to science in my brain, and it's coming out like I want to sleep.
I'm back.
Hello, back.
I'm sorry, Knives is a nosy little old lady.
Alright, so the difference is fruits and vegetables comprise different parts of the plants from which they grow. Fruits come from the flowering part of the plant and contain seeds. In contrast, vegetables are the edible parts of plants, such as the leaves, stems, roots, and bulbs. Cucumbers are a fruit,
mm-hmm.
because they have seeds in the middle and grow from the flower of a cucumber plant.
As I said, fruits have seeds.
Fine. I like a pickle.
Potato is a seed.
you want to hear a mind fuck right here?
What?
Strawberries are not technically a fruit. They are a series of multiple fruits.
Mm-hmm.
A strawberry is actually a multiple fruit which consists of many tiny individual fruits embedded in a fleshy receptacle.
Yeah.
So the part we enjoy eating is actually a fleshy receptacle. I'm just gonna call it that. I'm just gonna start calling strawberries fleshy receptacles.
No.
Helly is a fleshy fruit sack.
Is everybody back? We got Helly. Lady.
Ah.
Goat.
Wah. Ooh.
Delta.
Yeah, I've been here.
And Rat. All right.
Every little rustle she has to like investigate. So yeah, I'm sorry that took a while.
No problem. We left off with Braun looking over the helm that Lady was showing him.
I look at the helm. I identify the helm. Me and Helm are now BFFs.
It's in item cards.
It's in item cards. The helm. Helm is worn by iconic hero, Sir Varian, whose feats of fearlessness preceded him with it wherever he traveled. While wearing the helm, you can hold your breath for up to 3 times the normal duration. In addition, when you make a saving throw against being frightened, you can roll a d6 and add the number rolled to the save. This property can't be used again until the next dawn. Alright, there you go. You can now hold your breath. If you wanted to.
That is useless to me.
That is useless almost to everyone.
The helmet also gives you plus. The helmet also gives you +1 to AC, and you can wear the crown on a helmet.
Okay, fine.
Ruin. Maybe Ruin might want it. I don't know.
The helm would disappear if you put it on.
Mm-hmm.
Nah, I'm okay. I don't want it.
Ruin's fine. He already robbed all the good stuff from the lady.
Wow.
Seems that way, huh?
I don't feel right just leaving her there.
That's okay, she's a tree.
She wants it. This is what she wants. All druids love this.
She's so vulnerable. She's a vulnerable old lady. in the middle of a swamp.
She was already a vulnerable old lady in a swamp. Now she is a vulnerable old lady in a swamp that is also a tree. She's gaining nutrients from the soil and everything around her.
It's not like Shink can ever come back to this location.
After you could have just like rip her out of the ground and like take her with
her. Why don't you just ask her? Would you be cool with that? I'm probably hurt, but like her surgery hurts, but we still need it. It's up to you, Shane. Do you want to bring her with us? You want to bring Grandma with us?
No. Well, we're headed to Waterdeep, though.
Yeah.
And we don't know what's going on there.
Mm-hmm. It's up to you. I'm down to clown to go anywhere.
I would have liked to bring her to, like, another city or something, or town that she could like stay at, but I don't know.
Well, all's well that ends well. Let's head on. Also, did you check out the alchemy? Is that it for the alchemy? Anything else, Zesh?
Shrug.
Shrug. All right, yes. Shrug it is.
I don't think she's got anything that can help me in the long-term way I'm looking for.
Right.
But she has already helped with some useful advice.
Yes. Well then, all right. She, come along.
Also, just out of curiosity, Zesh is going to ask her one more question, and that is, does she happen to remember how long ago Rowan was taken from her?
Unfortunately, she has fallen into a deep sleep at this point, as you've all been kind of away from her. She's not going to be able to answer.
She'll be fine, I think.
It just works.
Okay. Give Shink a bird kiss.
Oh. Thank you. Hello, everybody. Thank you for the raid. Hello.
Hello, everybody. Welcome in.
Glad to meet all of you. We're in the middle of doing a stream. We are in the middle of a swamp right now. Hope you guys are having a wonderful time. Thank you for coming in. I really appreciate it. Oh, whoa. What were you guys up to? What were you guys doing? Go ahead, DM.
You all make your way back outside of Agatha's Wonders, and you're back out on the town.
Back out on the town.
Judging by her directions that she gave towards the higher road, you'd be heading north on the map, but it's actually like east. It just pointed up.
There's another house, though.
I know, that's a broken
smashed
down...
Smashed up one.
Smashed up one, yeah. It's across this little river.
I want to check it out.
Smash a little house.
Alright, go check it out, go up to it, and roll me an investigation. Before you roll me that investigation, roll me a dexterity check.
Okay.
Or rather, a save, sorry.
Oh.
You managed to hop back just in time as the floorboards, which have rotted over time, just fall through underneath your weight.
And then what do I... Investigation?
Investigation. Looking over what remains of this little house, you'll see what might have been once an inn. However, there are only smashed remains of most of it. It appears like as if some kind of explosion went off on the inside of it in a corner of the house, this corner specifically. Inside, the wood is rotting and just old. There has been zero upkeep done on this building itself. Any life that was once there has long since left.
So nothing has been left behind whatsoever?
Pretty much has been cleaned out long, long ago.
Okay.
Oh. That actually sounds funny. Oh, all right, Shink. Come along, Ellie.
Come on.
That does sound really great. I'm glad that you guys had a lot of fun. We're in a swamp.
That is funny, Michael. On Thursdays, I'm a player in my DM's game. We're also playing The Curse of Strahd, and we're mercenaries who are hired to kill Strahd.
Exactly, good guys. Exactly.
One of the characters literally robbed the town after setting it on fire.
It'd be cool if your, like, campaigns crossed.
That'd be cool to have two campaigns.
Well, we already murdered an adventuring party that tried to stop us.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Yeah, it was a dragonborn, an elf, a human, and I think a hag. Or maybe a sorcerer? I'm not entirely sure what she was. One was also a human wizard who was kind of an asshole to us previously and killed one of the player characters towards the beginning of the campaign with a fireball.
Sounds like Ron.
Alright, yep, yeah, you guys are back on the trail.
On the road again.
Towards the high road. Let me just check some stuff.
Damn, Ruin, you're fast!
Ruin, we're flying.
Oh shit, did I not reset the fog on this one?
We're flying around. Zipping around.
Let's see the sound.
Just flying away.
Give it just a second. Oh, okay, I remember this map. Alright, I've just gotta... Nope, that's the wrong button. Sorry, folks. Alrighty. Well, after a few hours of traveling along the trail, you do find yourselves on an actual road, as it is leading towards the high road and out of the swamp. In front of you stands a large expanse of a mountain, the tops and bottoms of which are framed in stalagmites and stalactites. Those of you who remember will remember some things involving this.
I feel like this map should have been flipped the other way.
Well, now it's traveling actual eastward.
Oh, okay.
Not sure. Should I make a history check?
Yeah, go ahead. It was for the reason for you.
Heck yeah. I got a go on that. Zesh remembers. She has business in
Ron,
there.
Ron, you remember a vision that you got when you spoke the pipe from the old mysterious man. That involved you traveling into this.
Oh, guys.
Something hidden inside.
I remember from that pipe weed. We need to go in there.
You need to remove the celestial.
Oh, right.
Keep him for an hour.
Only an hour.
That and pretty I'm bodacious just... weed.
Are you sure you're not gonna summon it again?
I'm going to have it saved to the side, so if she does, I have it.
Rat, I only have 2 fifth level spell slots.
Yeah.
And I have to spend one anytime I want to summon them.
Yeah, we only have so limited 5th levels over here. Me and her.
Where do
all right. Ruin, ready to go into the into the cool cave that I saw while I was high? Really cool. I was like really fucked up at that moment. But I thought of my pals.
Right, as you all begin entering the cave, it doesn't exactly smell what you would say is pleasant. It's damp, musky, and occasionally a breeze wafts through, and I'm going to need a perception check from everybody.
Let's see.
Oh, damn.
9. Shink, you're just super impressed with all the stalagmites and stalactites. And now we're just waiting on Heli.
Hello, Billy.
What?
In perception.
Heli doesn't want to. Perception. Just perception. Nah.
Alright, just like Shinky. Hell, you're just amused by all the stalactites and stalagmites and all the dripping bits here and there. As for the rest of you, you're going to realize this isn't a cave at all. And as the stalactites and stalagmites begin raising and lowering in unison.
Oh, well.
as the Tarrasque closes his mouth and begins moving.
Oh,
you can't see all of it. Meant.
And it was a Tarrasque all along. The moral of the story, kids, Tarrasque can be anywhere at any time.
Well, they're also so big that distance doesn't mean jack shit for them, really.
Wait, so we got eaten!
No, we didn't get eaten.
No, you've definitely been eaten.
No, we haven't been eaten. We have crawled in. There's a difference. Eden would mean that we have been chewed up and digested. It doesn't even know we exist. This is like going into Monstro. From that tale. You know, Pinocchio.
Are we just all dead?
No.
No, you're not dead. You are currently trapped inside the Tarrasque.
Trapped. Big words. I've got a spell that says otherwise. Got a real cool spell that says otherwise.
Oh, yeah, that's a great point. Hey, Bron, why don't you try something?
Nah, I'm cool. We're fine. My super cool weed high totally says I should be here, so I'm pretty chill, actually. I'm not afraid at all. That old man's weed, I feel it. I feel a bit of bravery.
That was a very long smoke ago. You're not feeling the high from that anymore.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, we have slept at least once since
then. Oh, yeah. No, I know.
And being conscious at least another time.
Yeah. No, Bron's more like, no. That old man has been speaking the truth so far. Why think this is any different? We're supposed to be here. But all right, we're here now.
Can we crawl out its mouth through its gap tooth right here?
Yeah.
Its mouth is closed. The gap between the molars still has a cheek on the other side of it.
Yeah, we gotta get through the cheek part. But that's okay, we can crawl through there eventually.
Start stabbing it.
No, that does nothing. No. I mean, we could give it a tummy ache.
Yeah, but going into its stomach means stomach acid.
You don't have to go into its stomach. The nasal cavity is connected. And through the nasal...
There's various channels you can go through.
Yeah, through the nasal cavity, you can easily go through the lungs and into the heart valve, and then we can kill it from the heart. It's simple. Just remember, things are connected. It's not just one tube.
Let me just, do the old death ward.
Alrighty. Are you using this as an item, or are you casting this?
Casting it.
Casting it? Alright. Zesh, as you go to cast this spell, you're not going to notice any change whatsoever. In fact, you're not even sure if the magic even activated.
Oh. There we go. Hello, Harbinger. Hello.
Hey, Darren.
Thank you for the raid. I really appreciate it. We're in the middle of streaming this. Thank you so much for coming in. We're in a giant creature's maw. Run. Run.
You said that there's a cheek on the other side of this gap?
Yeah. It just works.
Oh, yes, over here.
Hello, Hot, let's say hello.
Can I throw a shining stone at the cheek to try and, like, blast it open?
Sure, give me a roll on the, give me a D100.
It's a nice house. Very roomy, needs some furniture.
36. Give me just a second.
Ah, thank you so much, Heartless Halo, for the raid. Thank you guys all for the raid. I really appreciate it, guys. Yeah.
36. Roll me a D10.
Thank you so much for the raid. I really appreciate it, you guys. Yeah, I'll give you guys a follow. Not too bad. Thank you guys so much. Yeah. And thank you, Harbinger. Thank you, everybody. So much.
As you hit the stone against the cheek, there's no noticeable changes per se. Some of the teeth get a little whiter and younger looking. But that's about it. Some scars along the tongue will also disappear.
I heal it?
We're in a Tarrasque mouth.
Actually reversed its age by 5 years.
We're in a Tarrasque mouth.
Wait, does that mean it's gonna go to sleep then?
There's a good chance of that happening, and you are inside of it currently.
No.
Good job, Shink. Saving the world one strike at a time. So, gang, how are we going to get out of this situation? Hey. You know what?
I got business in here.
True, we have business.
I don't want to be in here.
Not Shink, I understand. But let's stay together. The old buddy system. Oh, that's right. Ruin. Oh. Now where do I go to get to the brain?
Tubes aren't generally connected to the brain.
Well, I can go to the heart, and that brings blood everywhere. And once I go to the heart, through the lungs, I can easily get to the brain, and then we can kill him.
I don't want to go further in.
Ruin. Oh, where are you going, Ruin?
I'm checking out this cave.
Ruin, as you're traveling down, you hear the beating of this beast heart get louder and louder.
Oh, okay. I'll keep going then.
It's business.
Aww. Shank just sits down. And refuses to go any further.
I leave my little buddy with Shank.
In just a second. This map has a lot of stuff to uncover.
And I go.
Alright, Ruin, you are currently in the beating heart of the beast.
Cool. Is it vibrating? Pulse?
It is pulsing underneath your feet. However, what pulses isn't what one would think when it comes to living creatures such as blood. You can't quite get the sense of what's beating in this heart, but there is something moving through this body.
Huh.
Almost all things need oxygen of some kind. Assume it has lungs.
Zesh is gonna try using one of the heckin' fancy candles to guide her way.
Ah, yeah, that's right. The fancy candles. The cool candles.
Alright, give me just a second. God damn it, right?
Sorry, I'm going too fast. I'll slow it down.
We love you, Chilin. We're sorry you're not feeling good.
Yeah, I gotta figure out how to do the polygon reveal with this bullshit.
There's a wall, or is that kind of walk in?
Hold on. Oh, there we go. Okay, I guess they fixed it. Alright, you can walk in there. That is an opening there.
Oh, okay.
What you find, Ruin, is an old dead lung. One of the lungs of the beast has long since shriveled and somewhat died. At the other end of it, you can see probably the most obvious cause for this is the side of a building.
Oh. Hmm.
Which you see there is a bit of rubble as the side, a portion of it has opened up, revealing some old dried blood that had pulled in there, as well as what appears to be a portion of a spiraling staircase. You know.
Let's go check it out. Where's it on? Oh, down there. Alright, I guess I'll walk over there. Check out what's going on.
What you see before you is a rounded wall that is currently what you assume would probably be the side of a spire of some sort.
All right. Walk. Can I walk in? Is this open?
Oh, yes, that is open.
All right, I'll walk in. Well, I guess I'm going
up further this way. You see no light, no nothing, except for the crushed remains of what was once the base of the spire. Whereas on this end, you see there is still some blood traveling a bit. Not a lot, but a little. After a few moments, the tongue is actually going to roll you back into the throat.
We all appreciate you guys. Ruin, what have you found?
We found a building. Oculus.
Oh, a building? My goodness. Shink! Oh, shoot.
Hey, bro, we could live here.
Oh.
Rhett, are you here? Rhett.
A creature to be feared.
Oh no. Rhett.
It's
Are you muted? Did you step away?
Who knows? Oof. Oof. Oh, she's hanging out with Zach.
But she's not she didn't say be right back or anything, did she?
No, I didn't hear her say that.
Oh, we still got like 13 minutes before the end of the session.
Yeah,
we could just end it early.
Yeah,
this is a good spot.
Yeah.
So, Ruin, how's that Vore kink working for you?
Not what?
Your Vore kink?
I didn't hear you.
Wow.
How's the what?
Your Vore kink.
Oh. It's alright. Same thing as always. Alright, since we're stopping on catch you early, do you have a raid target?
No.
Are you gonna keep going?
No. But who do you have a suggestion?
I was going live last.
Oh. Last. Do you want me to send it to you?
Okay,
you gotta go live.
I'm gonna need like 10-15 minutes to start.
Oh, okay, so you need 10-15 minutes before you start?
Yeah.
Well, we can send to somebody else.
Why am I further inside this thing?
Well, the tongue rolled you back. Also, what happened to you? Where'd you go?
Oh, I was talking to my mom.
Oh, we were trying to get you because everybody's calling you.
Let's just keep going.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Let's keep going for a bit. Let's take that raid, almost.
But yeah, Brat, Shink got rolled back into the throat. We still got 10 minutes to go on the session if we want to keep going, or we can end it right now.
I say keep going because I will take that raid.
Okay.
Not if I start live streaming right now.
That's fine. You are.
Guys, it's okay.
I'm going straight to fucking bed as soon as this is done. That is a valve off the side of the throat. You don't know what that is. It could be a, oh god, what is that called?
Is that the stomach?
No, that's a tonsil.
Oh. A tonsil?
Yeah.
It's a tonsil. Come on, this, doll.
This is the esophagus. This area right here. This is the breathing tube that also leads into the heart and the lungs. They're currently in one such lung calling out for you and Zesh.
I already said what Zesh was doing.
What was Zesh doing again? Sorry, refresh my memory.
Zesh was trying to use a candle to guide her way.
Does she have knowledge of what it is she's looking for?
She knows that her dream told her that something she needed was in here.
Alright, so without a clear idea of what it is you're looking for, the flame's just gonna flicker around in different directions.
I don't wanna be in here.
I'm tempted to just start stabbing it until it like spits me out.
Oh, you can certainly try stabbing it. Go ahead.
Okay, what do I have to roll?
Make an attack roll.
A stabbing roll, obviously. A roll to stab.
A 16. All right, as you bring the Black Rose rapier forward against the wall of the esophagus, you're going to hit the fleshy wall and the blade is going to slip along the side of it, dealing no damage at all.
Ew.
Yeah, it is also your Black Rose rapier's blade is now coated in Tarrasque mucus.
Oh.
Oh, great. Zesh, as you walk in, several parasites turn to look at you. Everybody roll initiative.
Oh, yeah.
We're not even...
Oh, right. Yeah, you're not even here yet, but there's... We gotta go turn by turn. Mm-hmm. We'll...
Sure, I'll roll initiative. Yeah, that'll be the last thing I do tonight.
Yeah, that's gonna be the last thing we're doing tonight.
I'm not ready to stream yet. Oh, well, you could just raid my streaming soon, I guess. My starting stream.
Just Chimera. Thank you so much.
And don't forget to click on your token when you roll for initiative. Heli.
Heli?
No, where's my token?
Where's my token? In the park.
I'm trying to watch this.
Thank you so much.
Damn, pretty decent rolls from everybody.
I appreciate a good D&D, thank you. I hope you appreciate a good artist as well, because that's what I am. A pretty alright good artist.
He's not alright or pretty decent, he's fucking good. He's an amazing artist.
What?
All the art you fucking see here is drawn by him, it's fucking insane. Just look at this DM thing he made for me. Fucking hood rocks, it kicks ass.
Oh, thank you. Oh, wait, thank you. Thinkies.
Is that okay with you, Goat? The starting soon screen?
Yeah, just...
Okay, give me one second and I'll start it.
Yeah, let me see if it's on so I can just grab it.
Grab what? Oh, me?
Yeah, so I can just grab it and copy-paste.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So what are you gonna stream,
Kelta? Dog and
Rampa. Oh, okay.
I'm finishing a chapter.
All great artists are humble, let's be honest. Oh, that's not actually true. That's not true. There are some great artists that are full of themselves. One of the greatest artists that I think in the past 200 years was completely full of himself. He had a live anteater and everything. He did not give a fuck.
What the fuck? He had an anteater?
Yeah, he had it on a leash and he threw it onto a live host because it was funny.
Nice.
He sent a picture of a dead bird to a girl he liked and then sent his subject matter to her as well.
Yeah, but did she like it? That's the question.
I mean, she liked it, but her mom didn't.
I showed you my dead bird. Show me your dead...
No, it was a dead mouse. It was a dead mouse in a bottle. And then...
A bottle.
Then he sent the actual dead mouse in a bottle. He was a fucking hilarious artist. And he's just like, fuck modern art. I'm the best.
Alright, I'm gonna start up right now. I'll catch you guys later.
No problem.
Have a good one, bud.
See you later.
Yeah, the lady knows the name of the artist. Right, lady?
Man, she stopped listening like 1,000 years ago.
Is it Dolly?
Yeah.
I can...
What? What's wrong?
Everyone's far away and I'm about to get hit a bunch.
Oh no, you'll be fine. I will be fine. We'll come for you.
Isn't your AC like 20?
21 now, 22. I think. 22, yeah.
Man.
Look at that helmet. That's like fucking plus one to AC right there.
Yeah. And then the artist that made the saxophone, he was a fucking asshole who was full of himself. He didn't give a fuck. He thought that he was so amazing that he was the definition of new sound in France. Even though he was kicked out of Italy, and in France, it was only adopted for 5 years, then gone, and came back in America in the jazz age. I think in the 1930s, actually.
You know what? Considering the jazz age was right around, like, at the tail end of the Blue Age.
Yeah.
I'm like pretty sure somebody sold their soul to the devil and he just gave him a saxophone.
Yeah, and he's like, you try to learn from this, and then they're like, bet? And
then... this fucked up some other dude's life. He kept trying to be famous. But here you go.
Yeah, well, for you. The funniest thing is that he did reinvent the bass clarinet. The bass clarinet sucked, and he reinvented it.
Oh, that thing still fucking sucks.
It sounds way better. Originally, it had a garbage tone and everything. It was horrid.
Oh,
like it made no sense to be in the band, but it still had a technical place. Where now the bass, where the bass clarinet actually does sit pretty well.
Ernest Hemingway is still one of my personal heroes.
I'm talking about artists who are full of themselves and know they're amazing.
Hey, this is Ernest fucking Hemingway we're talking about. This dude was off his fucking rocker. He knew he was amazing. He was an amazing writer who went and hunted pirates in a fucking dinghy with a box full of grenades.
He did do that! Oh shit, that was Ernest Hemingway. Hell yeah!
Aren't you Hemingway?
Oh, he's just as crazy as Andrew Jackson, who fucking...
Okay.
Go ahead.
But what about heckin' Peter Thundershield?
I don't know who that is, but it sounds like a D&D character.
Who kept giving him grenades? Good question.
Peter Thundershield is a weirdo who was in, like, a navy at one point.
Yeah.
And all of the other, like, officers hated him, but the king loved him because he kept winning. And he did that by just not fighting like everyone else did.
Yeah.
He was fucking crazy.
Peter Tordenskiold, or Thundershield, was...
Including the time where he was fighting a guy by shooting at him and sailing away, shooting at him and sailing away, shooting at him and sailing away.
Yeah. And then
he sent out, like... a dinghy to board their ship and ask them for cannonballs.
Yeah.
Because he was having he was really having fun fighting them. And they gave them to him.
Captain Cook was also a really funny explorer, in all honesty. He's a hilarious explorer. Who was like, yeah, there's an island out there. They're like, no, there is not an island out there. Yes, there is. There's an island, I promise.
The One Piece is real.
And he found it and they ate him.
Did you say they hate him or they ate him?
They loved him so much that they ate him. They wanted to gain his powers, but he was a dying man, and it's conflicting results, but a lot of people believe that Captain Cook was already on his deathbed, but didn't want to be eaten. The people of Hawaii knew that, and they were going to give him the honorable death. and bring his spirit and his memories with him and keep his memory going.
You do that by throwing him in a volcano.
Yeah. So yeah, there's Peter Tolden Azure or Light or Thunder Shield, and then there's Light Toller, who literally is a original captain of the Titanic, who was going to go down with the ship, and then an air pocket hit, and he was flung out of the ship.
That sounds like some made up bullshit.
It sounds like some made up bullshit. I know. He
definitely got on one of those shows, like little dinghies, like just escaping out with the rest of them. He just dressed in like normal clothes.
Here's the thing. Everybody, I would agree if this was an autobiography. It was not his autobiography. It was done by many people that saw it firsthand. That's what we hear, is that it's from multiple different people being like, yeah, he just kind of flew out. And they're like, what?
This dude's over here, like, doing like the Napoleon thing where he's got like his hand being held in the jacket. And he's like, to go down with one ship is the greatest of honors.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden fucking gets hit with a fucking air pocket.
Yeah.
And gets shot fucking out. Like, what the fuck is this shit? Like, God's like, live with it.
Genuinely, here's the thing. It's multiple people's accounts. That's why I've got to be like, okay, it's got to be real. All right. Okay,
it's like that chef that was on the Titanic that got off. Mm-hmm. And then he went on the next ship. He fucking got on, also sank.
Yeah, and the lady servant as well. Yeah, the servant lady and also the chef that survived. Yeah, three people.
They need to remake the Final Destination movies, the Titanic theme.
Yeah, no, we love history here. We love stupid history. Here's the thing. We love stupid history. We love, like, interesting, fun little facts like that. Like, Attila the Hun had multiple children.
Oh my god, dude, like, fathered half the fucking country.
Yeah. He was genuinely, like, it seemed like he was actually a genuine ruler. Where a lot of people are like, yes, he was awful and monstrous. It's like, bro, you literally built an army to fight him. He is going to fight you. He stated in many of his stories, it was, do not fight me. Do not start raising an army. I will not fight you. And then they're like, oh no, we're just going to raise an army. And he's like, fucking, what did I say? What did I fucking say? I told you. And he fucking burned villages to the ground because literally, he gave them a second chance and they said, nah, fuck you. And it's like, okay, all right, I guess I'll burn you to the ground and make sure you never come back. Yeah, no, I love
him. Let's not forget that he's the sole reason the Great Wall of China exists.
Yeah, he is the reason that thing exists, so, you know. It's the greatest he's structure.
Still got
yeah. Oh, he still got her. Yeah, that's the best part. And it still wasn't good enough.
I think it was even like, what? He like complimented the architecture of the wall and still fucking climbed over that shit.
Yeah, he's like, oh, this is a masterful part of the wall. And I got over it in less than an hour. Oh, well. He's like, he did have to restructure his army because of the wall, but he's like, you know.
That was like a Thursday for him.
Yeah, he's like, okay, all right. I'll have to restructure my army, but okay. Not a problem to me. No, we love dumb history. We love stupid shit like that. But thank you guys so much for coming in. Thank you guys for being so awesome. Thank you guys for being so incredible and amazing. We appreciate every single one of you guys. please consider following any of these wonderful people, and remember, you guys are awesome. Thank you guys for coming in, and thank you guys for being great.
We all had fun.
Yeah. All right, guys. Oh, not a problem. I'm here almost every other night. So,
We do D&D every Wednesday night.
Yeah, we do D&D every Wednesday night, and I'm always streaming. So, I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye. Hell yeah, bye-bye. D&D tomorrow. Hell yeah. Well, good luck on that.
I also have D&D tomorrow.
Ooh, you're the DM. Ooh, well.
No, I'm not the DM. Oh, you're the DM.
Yeah, they're the DM. Bye-bye.